You see bald eagles and golden eagles in their daily routine.
It's an age-old predator-prey game amid timeless rimrock country at Lake Billy Chinook near Madras, Oregon.
You never know what's going to be going on at one of the viewpoints or at the Overlook Park.
A place where three rivers called Metolius, Crooked, and Deschutes merge into a seven-mile-long watery playground. Long a drawing card for eagles.
These big escarpments that you see, you don't see those everywhere. And they like a certain steepness, and then they gotta have some flat ledges on it, because you'll see some of them that are literally sheer. They have to have a little bit of a place to start a nest, but it is special.
Less than an hour down the Deschutes River, explore a direct route to Solitude on a gentle road that winds for more than 40 miles. The lower Deschutes backcountry byway is surrounded by canyon walls that tower above lonesome boaters who own the river this time of year. Many of the columnar basalt cliffs reach hundreds of feet high.
He probably went back and bedded against the cliff.
It's where wildlife biologist Jeremy Thompson watches for movement among the rocks.
In the sun, they kind of shine yellow. I've heard them described as bananas, looking for bananas on the hill. But the curve of that horn and the color of it really stands out.
The Deschutes River byway hides bighorns, and it takes a keen eye to pick out the wild sheep that blend with the background. Females, called ewes, gather in small herds.
They're pretty gregarious. They like to hang out together throughout the entirety of the year. So you'll find little groups like that. You know, there'll be 10 to 12 generally throughout the summer and the fall.
The males, called rams, are more solitary.
Once a ram gets over a year and a half old, I mean, his horns are well bigger than what a ewe's will be. So you'll start to see horns that curve way back and much bigger at the base than what you'd see on the females.
The Deschutes bighorns are inspiring. Not only their dramatic stature against an otherwise drab background of rock and sage, but the fact they are even here. You see, overhunting and disease led to extinction of Oregon's bighorn sheep in the 1940s. But restoration projects began in 1954, when 20 sheep were relocated from British Columbia to the Heart Mountain National Antelope Refuge in Lake County. Other states also contributed to Oregon's sheep recovery efforts through the 1980s. By the 90s, Oregon's population was strong enough to support in-state capture and transplant, and Heart Mountain was bighorn central for many winters. Helicopters were the most efficient and cost-effective tools. Bighorn capture depends upon teamwork between the pilot and his gunner, who sits near the open side door. The twosome choose an animal and descend a few yards above it, and then speed along across the ground. At just the right moment, the gunner fires his handheld net gun. A 30 caliber blank propels four weighted ends of a 15 square foot mesh net. It wraps around the animal like a huge bag. Once the animal's been caught, a third team member, called a mugger, jumps to the ground, blindfolds the animal, and preps it for air delivery to base camp. Five years later, the process has changed little. Leading Edge Aviation of Clarkston, Washington works with Oregon wildlife managers to capture bighorns in Oregon.
Everyone has their jobs to do. Should run through pretty smooth.
The Deschutes River Canyon population has rebounded so well, sheep can be caught here and moved to other locations to establish new herds. At base camp, careful and quiet work is critical.
Swabs, vaccines.
Speaking little and only in hushed tones.
As soon as he's done with blood, you guys are good.
The teams work quickly to process each animal.
Blood, genetics.
They monitor the bighorn's temperature.
3.8.
Collect blood samples and inject vaccines to protect against disease.
As you can see with how we handle them, we try to minimize external stimuli, we try to keep quiet, make sure that they are blindfolded, we're not making loud noises. It's taken years for us to figure out, as soon as you have a single job for each person and you kind of work as a unit, it goes very smoothly, and that all ties into the same thing, just decreasing the time and stress on that sheep and getting them off the table. So yeah, it helps a lot to work well as a team.
This month, 26 bighorns, including many captured along the Deschutes, were moved to the Klamath River Canyon in southern Oregon for release. It's been more than a century since bighorns lived here.
Steep rocky terrain. They like the real, you know, steep, craggly, rocky terrain that affords them that cover. They'll start moving around in their new environment here, and we've got radio collars on to monitor their movements and survival, so we'll be tracking that very closely.
While the helicopter capture project is expensive, the costs are offset by the sale of hunting licenses, tags, and permits.
It's definitely one of ODFW's success stories, and it's nice to be a part of something that's working so well.
Back on the byway with Jeremy Thompson, he says if you wish to come and see the bighorns, dress warm, don't forget binoculars, and most of all, bring
patience. A lot of people will stop and look and not see them and move on. You know, if you just sit down and watch and look at some of these bigger cliff complexes, eventually they'll be surprised. There'll be sheep in them and they just haven't been able to see them.
The bighorns now number nearly 5,000 in more than 40 sites across eastern Oregon. It's a special program blending human technology with a commitment to restore species.